As the controversy around the 8-lane Salem-Chennai Expressway continues, Mirana spoke to the Salem District Collector, who said that people will be given adequate compensation for their land and said that only a few of the landowners are protesting against the expressway. Remember, villagers have been protesting against this project because it will take up several hectares of forest as well as farmland.
For the 8-lane road which runs from Salem to Chennai, National Highways Authority of India has already come up with the DPR, the Detailed Project Report, and the pattadars whose land is going to be acquired by the government for this project are going to be given the compensation as per the fair, Right to Fair Compensation Act. For the people's benefit, I will tell it in a layman's language, that if the guideline value of a particular area is say 1 lakh rupees, they would be getting at least maybe 3 times of the guideline value, which comes out to be 3 lakh rupees, which generally matches with the market value of that area. And it's not only about the land compensation, it is about everything that is there on the land.
How much farmland is being acquired for this project in Salem alone?
Yeah, around 272 hectares of farmland, the patta land. It may not be necessarily farmland, patta land is going to be acquired under this project. 36 kilometers of the road runs in Salem district.
Apparently for the past 4 days, we could see like farmers protesting outside, claiming that the revenue officers or the landmarkers did not get their permission even before entering the land. Why is this conspiracy occurring now?
See, there are some procedures under in the NHAI Act in which once the notification under 3A is published, that means that they know that their land is going to be measured for the acquisition purpose. Then we had given them 21 days time to raise their claims and objections.
To the farmers?
Yes. To the farmers, to everyone whose land is going to be acquired, as per the paper notification, we have given them 21 days time. In those 21 days also, we had put up a special help desk for them to come and give their claims and objections. So in that also, we got some claims and objections. Afterwards, the procedure mandates that we go there and fix the boundary stones. Only after fixing the boundary stones, we'll get to know as to whether there is any variance as per the DPR and as per the field. Even after this, there will be another chance for the pattadars to come and raise their objection or ask for higher compensation directly to the land acquisition officer, who is district revenue officer.
But they cannot deny stating that they will not provide the land. That is not possible. Accusation is confirmed.
As per this act, there is no need of any consent by the landowners is not a prerequisite for this particular act, because this is a public infrastructure facility. Out of 855 pattadars, only single digit people have objected, and we are have got in touch with them individually as to what exactly they need.
Let's go across to Pramod, who's joining us. Pramod, from what we just heard her say, that it seems like all the rules were followed, the entire procedure was followed in terms of this entire land acquisition that is going on for this particular project. But that's not the same story that you seem to be getting from the farmers who are objecting to this, is it?
Well, definitely not. I'm in fact inside one of the fields, and you could see this is a complete tapioca field, close to 6 acres around. And the farmers over here were the people who protested yesterday, because the surveyors had come here yesterday and they have like marked the lands. In fact, I have the owner of the farm land with me itself. He also made it very clear that nobody took the permission from himself to enter this land before getting this kind of marking this lands. And I also asked the collector one important question about if this particular thing, will the farmers have to give their consents or not? They said there is no need for the farmer's consent, and that is what is causing a lot of fear. Let me just ask him. Aiyah, Nathan, you want to go land alone? Edit that, Angela. If on the land, when the road pop up, the person is doing this. If you go land, you get cut. Tayara Kingla.
காரணம்னா எங்களுக்கு இதுதான் இருக்குதுங்க. இதை வாழ்வாதாரமே இதுதான் பிழைக்கிறது வழி இதுதான். இதுக்கு மேலே நாங்கள் அரசாங்கத்துக்கு போகணும்னு வேலை தனியார் கம்பெனிக்கு போகணும்னு எதோ இதை வச்சுட்டு பொழைச்சிட்டு இருக்கோம். இதை கொடுத்துட்டு நாங்கள் எங்கே போகிறது?
வெல் ஹீஸ் திஸ் இஸ் குப்புசாமி, த ஓனர் ஆஃப் திஸ் லேண்ட், அண்ட் இஸ் 71 years old. ஹீ கிளைம்ஸ் அட் ஹீஸ் பின் ஹியர் ஃபார் த பாஸ்ட் 6 generations, அண்ட் ஹி சேட்ஸ் ரைட் நவ் ஹீஸ் நாட் ரெடி டு கிவ் திஸ் லேண்ட், பிகாஸ் திஸ் லேண்ட் வாஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி யூஸ்லெஸ் வென் ஹீ கேம் இன் ஃபேமிலி கேம் ஓவர் ஹியர், பட் தே ஹவ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி கன்வெர்ட்டட் இன் டு அ ப்ராப்பர் லேண்ட் அண்ட் தே லவ் இட் சோ மச் அட் ஈவன் நோ மேட்டர் வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் காம்பன்சேஷன் is provided, they are not ready to give it. But collector said avanga vandu kittadatta pala kodi tharan sollirukangala
ennikku eppanga yetla chakrana inichira podaanga adalla tharamaatanga adalla tharad summa adala adalla naanga pesave venda naanga nilam thara thayara illa.
Well, for no matter how much the compensations were provided, they are not ready to provide the land. I have ama neenga solunga ungalku indha maari idu pannirukanga ettu vali sala modhula thevan nenikiringla
andha velaiya nenachadinga munna எட்டு வழி சாலையே எங்களுக்கு வேணாம், எங்கள் சொத்து இருந்தால் எங்களுக்கு போதும் சாமி. இதுதான் எங்களுடைய அபிப்பிராயம். அதெல்லாம் அதுக்கு மீறி எடுக்க வந்தாங்கன்னா எங்களை வேணால் குழி நோண்டி புதைச்சி விட்டு அதுக்கு மேலே வேணால் ரோட்டை போட்டுக்கிட்டு போட்டோம். எங்களுக்கு இது தேவையில்லை, எங்கள் பொருள் இருந்தால் எங்களுக்கு போதும்.
Well, it's very unfortunate the way she's trying to explain it. She claims that there is no need for an 8-lane in Salem right now, and not just that. She says, like, if they want to go ahead and make this particular agricultural land into a road, they should bury them underneath this road and only progress. This is a kind of emotion that is on the ground. Aya, ipo Salathil illa edha nariya road edha irukku illa idu pinna vandu po ettu vali saala venu nu solranga idu mari oru veda vandu ungalku indha saala vandu avlo mukkiyama oru andha mari vyavasaya nalathukku pala pora mari
vyavasaya nalathukku pora mari saala mukkiyam illaiya. இப்போ இருக்கிற சாலைக்கே போகிறதுக்கு வண்டி இல்லைங்க. அவங்க சொல்கிறாங்க இன்னும் 20 வருஷத்து பின்னாடி நீங்கள் யோசனை பண்ணி பாருங்கள். அன்னைக்கு 20 வருஷம் வரையில் ஏன் இவ்வளோ காசு வேஸ்ட் பண்ணோம்? அது அன்னைக்கு போட்டு போகிறது, அன்னைக்கு வந்து இன்றைக்கி 1 கோடி ரூபா தருது, அன்னைக்கு 2 கோடி ரூபா போட்டு போட்டு போகலாம். 20 வருஷத்தில் எத்தனை கோடி ரூபா சம்பாதிக்கலாம்? இதெல்லாம் இன்றைக்கி வந்து அது தேவையே இல்லைங்க. சேலம் மாவட்டத்துக்கு தேவையில்லை.
Well, he made it very clearly like that this Salem district does not require an 8-way lane because there are already many roads. 3 highways are connecting it to Chennai and you have proper railways as well. And he states that as per the government's authority and the policy, if this lane is important for the after next 20 years, why can't they construct it then? Why do they have to destroy farmlands right now? So he claims that the policy itself is wrong in the writing process itself.
Right, so Pramod, at this point, it's not about the money clearly, because from what I understood, they're going to be getting more than what the land is actually worth in terms of compensation. The farmers just don't want to part with their land.
Absolutely, because this is actually a farmer's belt. It's a agricultural belt, and for them, land is everything. Salem has been one of the very important areas, and you could see around us how fertile the land is. This is a tapioca. We have tapioca, and we have a paddy and a coconut, and a lot of things are like inhabited in this 6-acre land alone. And these are farmers who've been owning this land for more than 6 generations. So it is a part of their family. And imagine this person, a 70-year-old person, he claims that he's been working in this land since 4 a.m. of his life every day. And if the government comes forward and says, like, we want this land for a highway, they claim that like, there are so many other wastelands which they could use and there is no possible way, they have to take it over here. However, he also mentions one important thing. Let me show you to the right side. There is a kind of like a institution on that area, and the land, the road is going on this side but not touching that one. So they're like asking questions, how is that like certain farmlands are given areas are given priority and farmlands are only been collected. For instance, in front of me we have a government school that will also be removed, but not that institution. That's a private institution. These are the questions, very, very serious questions that are put forward by the farmers and the landowners here, and for which there is no answer. In fact, when we asked the collector directly, we asked her asking, like, does Salem have the infrastructure? Is it having an infrastructure to hold an 8-lane way? She just said that this is a policy decision, and that's all she can say about this particular decision. So that is a kind of like a mindset that's been over here, where the people claim that the district of Salem does not need an 8-way lane because there are already so many roads that could be properly maintained, which could allow traffic.
All right. Thanks, Pramod, for getting us all those details and getting us those voices as well. But at this point, it doesn't seem like the farmers are going to have any choice in the matter about the land acquisition. Like the district collector said, it's not a matter of choice. The land is going to be acquired.